Just like go dotted in.
Most of these are like the empties of like, I don't know what drawing they were for, but yeah, that's my pen. You know, sometimes they stop working at a certain point too, where you'll notice like a metallic sheen to it or something for some reason. So then I'll ditch it and start a fresh one. What's up, guys? I'm Paul Kobriger. Here in my garage. This is where I do my frames and my drawings. I just started drawing with ballpoint like 4 or 5 years ago. I've only been doing it a couple years. The first drawing I ever did with a pen was the Transworld cover of Wes Kremer, Frontside 360, shot by Blayback. I was like, oh, that's a rad black and white, high contrast photo. Like, that would be good for a ballpoint pen. So I just started drawing that. My type of art is photorealism or hyperrealism, that's what it's called, which is like, there's a pour, get that pour in the exact place, like get the beard hair. It all starts with a good reference photo, that's the beginning. So yeah, for the Grosso piece, I found a rad photo, Joe Brook shot it. It was just like, Grosso, look up or whatever, and just snapped it. It was just real candid. Having a vision of what the completed piece is gonna be motivates you to get through it, but most nights it's just work. It's like, it's basically an hour a square inch is what it comes down to. Yeah. Sometimes 2 hours, depending on the detail. Like, but now I do like a grid, so I'll grid it out in Photoshop, the photo, and then I don't know. I used to do the really tight grids to make sure everything was perfect, and now I'm better at it where it's probably like a 1-inch grid, and I just kind of, like I said, if the pupils and the nostrils and the corner of the mouth are all in the right place, and maybe the hairline, that's all I really need. And now I'm, you know, more confident. When I did Lance, Ray, and Gons, and then I was doing an art show, and I was trying to figure out a way to display those drawings, like the originals. And I was like, man, it'd be cool to have their like iconic. They all have iconic 80s graphics that everybody knows. I wonder if there's a way to like include them in the piece. Because there's different colorways and different ways to arrange the graphic. So even if somebody's getting a print with the frame, it's all custom and they're getting kind of an original piece with it. So I was looking at Grosso graphics and trying to figure out which one that I could get my hands on, and also that would best work for, you know, to template around or whatever. So yeah, I'll figure out the right layout, and then that'll be, I kind of did some of the pre-cuts already, but, you know, knowing that it's going to be done, you're going to get to post it, people are going to see it, like, it's rad to see people's reactions. Yeah, so ballpoint, you can shade just like you do with a pencil. It's just kind of how much pressure, you know. That's what I don't know, people trip out on that I use ballpoint, but it's really not that different than a pencil. The only thing is you can't erase it, you can't like really fix it, so you got to go real slow.